Quadratic Equations, Factoring, Level 4. In the previous three videos, we solved quadratic equations of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0. Now we will focus in solving quadratic equations of the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, also known as quadratic trinomials, because they contain three terms: the quadratic term ax squared, the linear term bx, and the constant term c. Keep in mind that unlike quadratic binomials, quadratic trinomials are not always solvable by factoring. But for those that are factorable over the integers, this technique works just fine. There are two types of quadratic trinomials that can be solved by factoring. The first type are quadratic trinomials of the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where a equals 1, and the other type are of the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where a is greater than 1. We will first focus on the type for which a equals 1, since it's the easiest. We will then work our way to the case where a is greater than 1. Recall that factoring a quadratic equation involves writing a polynomial into linear factors. For the case when a equals 1, if the quadratic equation of the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0 is indeed factorable over the integers, then its linear factors will have the following form: the quantity x plus r times the quantity x plus s. Now let's find the product of these two linear factors. One way we can find the product is by distributing each term in the first factor with each term of the second factor. In other words, we distribute by using the FOIL method. I'm actually going to find the product geometrically, as follows. Recall that the area of a rectangle is equal to the length times its width. If we let the quantity x plus r equal the width, and let x plus s equal the length of a rectangle, then we can divide this rectangle into four regions, each with their own area. They include x times x, or x squared, r times x, s times x, and r times s. This diagram shows that the product of the quantity x plus r times the quantity x plus s is equal to x squared plus rx plus sx plus rs, since both of these expressions represent the same area. The expression in the right side of the equal sign can be simplified by adding rx and sx, since they are like terms. Doing that, we obtain the following expression: x squared plus the quantity r plus s times x plus rs, which represents a quadratic trinomial of the form x squared plus bx plus c. By aligning these equations side by side, I want you to notice that the coefficient of the x term, in this case b, is equal to the sum of r and s, and the constant term, in this case c, is equal to the product of r and s. For example, if we had the following quadratic polynomial in factored form, and if we rewrite it as a trinomial by FOILing, we would obtain x squared plus 8x plus 15. Notice that the coefficient of the linear term, the value for b, is equal to 8, which is equal to the sum of 3 and 5. In addition, the constant term c is equal to the product of 3 and 5. This example suggests the following method for factoring trinomials whose quadratic coefficient is 1. This method has two steps. First, list the pairs of factors whose product equals the constant term c. And second, find the pair of factors in the list whose sum equals the coefficient of the linear term, in this case, b. Let's show how this is done with a couple of examples. We will first go over an example where both b and c contain positive coefficients. Solve the equation x squared plus 12x plus 20 equals 0. Alright, first thing I want you to notice is that we are dealing with a quadratic equation of the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0, also known as a quadratic trinomial, because it contains a quadratic term, a linear term, and a constant term. Let's find out if this quadratic equation can be solved by factoring. First step is to make sure it's in standard form, with the degree of the terms in descending order. Notice that this equation is already in standard form, and it's also equal to 0 on one side of the equation. So we go ahead and proceed with the factoring step. For the factoring step, we are going to make a table, listing the pairs of factors of positive 20 in one column. The best way to approach this is by starting with the number 1 and work your way until you obtain all factors. Doing that, we have the following factors, whose product is equal to positive 20: 1 times 20, 2 times 10, and 4 times 5. all of these pairs are factors of positive 20, and their product also equals positive 20. This is essentially what we are looking for. Now the next question you should ask yourself is, which pair should I use? To answer that question, we need to also find the sum of each of these pairs. We go ahead and write them in the second column. The first pair add up to 21. The second pair add up to 12. And the third pair adds up to 9. We're looking for the pair whose product gives us 20 and add up to 12. We see that the numbers in the second row are a perfect match. This means that we are going to use 2 and 10 to represent our R and S in the factored form of this quadratic trinomial. Replacing R and S, we obtain the quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x plus 10. As a check, I recommend that you expand the factors. In other words, FOIL this expression just to make sure that you factored correctly. Let's go ahead and do just that. The first term gives us x squared, the outer terms gives us 10x, and the inner terms gives us 2x, and the last terms gives us 20. Next, we add like terms, in this case, 10x and 2x, which simplifies to 12x. And there you go. It checks out. We obtain the original quadratic expression. So we are confident that we factored the quadratic trinomial correctly. We are not done yet. Once we factor the equation, we go ahead and apply the zero product property. So we set each factor equal to zero. Then we solve for x for each linear equation, giving us x equals negative 2 as one solution, and x equals negative 10 as a second solution. Alright, let's try the last example. Solve the equation y squared minus 6y plus 9 equals 0. Notice that we are again dealing with a quadratic trinomial that is in standard form and is also equal to 0 on one side of the equation. So the first step is done. Also notice that the coefficient on b is negative, and the coefficient on c is positive. This makes the problem slightly harder. We will see why this is the case. Let's go ahead and see if this quadratic trinomial is factorable. So let's create our table and find the factored pairs whose product is equal to 9. Like always, let's start with 1 and work our way until we get them all. The first pair is 1 times 9. The second pair is 3 times 3. Next, we go ahead and find the sum of these pairs. For the first pair, we have that their sum is equal to 10. For the second pair, their sum is equal to 6. At first hand, it seems that we found our factors, but there is one problem. Their sum equals positive 6, and we are looking for negative 6. Is there a way to obtain negative 6 with these positive factors? The answer is no. But remember, factors are not only positive, they are also negative. When you have a quadratic equation whose linear term coefficient is negative, and whose constant term is positive, then both pairs of factors have to be negative, so that the product yields a positive number, and their sum yields a negative number. This is exactly what we are looking for. So don't bother using positive factors when b is negative and c is positive. Knowing this, we go ahead and find the negative factors of 9. They are negative 1 times negative 9, and negative 3 times negative 3. Notice that both pairs still give us positive 9, because a negative times a negative equals a positive. Next, let's go ahead and find their sums. The first pair add up to negative 10, and the second pair add up to negative 6. And bingo, we found the factors whose product equals 9 and sum equals negative 6. We go ahead and use these pairs as our R and S to factor the quadratic trinomial and obtain the quantity y minus 3 times the quantity y minus 3. Like always, make sure you mentally FOIL the expression to make sure you obtain the original quadratic expression. Having successfully factored the quadratic expression, we go ahead and apply the zero product property to each factor. So we set each factor equal to 0 and solve for the variable. Doing that, we obtain y equals 3 as one solution and y equals 3 as a second solution. We essentially have a repeated root for this particular quadratic equation. Alternatively, we could also rewrite the factored expression as the quantity y minus 3 squared, and then solve by taking the square root of both sides and then solving for the variable. In the end, we would obtain the same solution. Alright, in our next video we will continue working with quadratic equations of the form x squared plus bx plus c equals 0.